I love it. I love everything about this.
Welcome to the abyss, assholes.
Oh, you're not fine.
Even the GM.
As you guys are following along this dog, how much distance are you keeping between you and the dog? I mean, it's the difference of, like, trying to keep up with it as it's moving along outside the fence, or trying to keep it, like, on the edge of your vision as you move.
I'm not trying to keep up with it, because I'm pretty sure that, considering it's whimpering, I can hear it fine enough to follow it.
Okay, so you're going to stay some distance away from the dog. It stops and starts sniffing the air very intently. And then its head snaps around. And when I say its head snaps around, I don't mean it moves its whole body and shoulders to turn and look at you. I mean its head swivels on its neck like an owl's. And it's looking directly at Riot.
All right, that sounds unsettling.
Alright, maybe it wouldn't be as much fun as I was thinking.
What's next?
It wouldn't be as fun as you think.
Right, we'll take a couple steps back. It's clearly looking right at her.
And the thing begins limping in your direction, and it starts barking loudly.
Shit.
And its bark sounds horrible. Like, try to picture, like a pit bull who smoked for 70 years.
Wow.
That's what this is sounding like coming out of this thing's throat.
Yeah, Serenity's gonna run up and snap its neck.
And snap its neck? Okay, so...
Yeah.
So you're gonna try to meet it at... Because you got a fence in between you and it.
Oh, sorry.
I mean, you can easily reach through the fence and snap its neck once it gets close enough.
Okay, that sounds great.
Excellent, okay. Let's roll some initiative.
Okay.
God damn it.
Serenity, what's yours?
18.
18.
Burning a point to gain advantage on this.
Don't do that yet.
Second.
Don't do that yet. Because this might be over after the dog and Serenity.
Okay.
The dog breaks out into the best it can do is a run once it notices there's more things there. Serenity inches up to the gate. The dog's going to get a bite at you first because it won initiative over you. And you're going to reach in and try to snap its neck.
Yep, that seems like fun.
That does seem like fun. And
it's just going to be a wind-up dog.
Snaps out. And the dog is not so big that it can't fit between the bars. It could squeeze through with some doing. But it doesn't do so at first. First, it just sticks its snout out and tries to snap at you. But you definitely move your arm out of the way and go ahead and roll a grapple attack.
That's strength and proficiency.
I'm sorry?
That's strength plus proficiency.
Oh, it's not going to matter.
It's a to-hit roll, yeah. So it's your strength plus your proficiency.
Yeah, that misses. I rolled a one.
That misses?
Yeah.
And you go to get your arm around this thing's neck, thinking to snap it. But as you do, you feel its head swivel with the motion of your arm. So what's everybody else's initiative now that it's going to matter? Ciclon.
Okay. Ciclon burning a point on that.
Okay.
Is now on a... on a 23.
23, so I'll have you act next. What about Mahogany?
15.
And Riot?
21.
You guys know me and Serenity are supposed to go first, right?
Ciclone, it's you. Right now, Serenity has her arm around this dog's neck, but is not getting purchase enough to snap it, and the dog is snapping its jaws at Serenity's arm.
About how far out am I?
You're far enough. You can attack it this turn if you want.
Because I would like to break into a run and try and silence it because we don't need noise right now.
Do it.
That's like the negative thing that we need right now.
So how are you silencing it? Just with punches?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you see?
23 to hit.
That's good.
6 damage.
And you get a punch into this thing's neck, and you feel blood on your hand where this thing has recently been in a fight. Something has clawed it up pretty good. And it was barking and snapping a moment ago, but then you just hear a slight whimper, a yelp. And then it slumps to the ground. So, Serenity, you're kind of left there with this dog slumped in your head and the worst blue balls you've ever felt in your life.
I'll look at Serenity and say, that wasn't fun.
And just about
you got it first.
Just about that time, you hear a little, you hear some more barking in the direction where the dog came from. Or, I'm sorry, the dog was headed to.
Ooh, I can get the next one. I'm gonna pull my maul off my back.
God damn it.
All of you are medium sized, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, so you could squeeze into this fence at any point. But the alarm has been raised. You hear the barking and baying of more of these backwards dogs off in the distance.
I'm gonna keep, wait, are we still on initiative?
We will be once more dogs show up. I'm gonna keep the same initiative.
Yeah, well, we're close enough to our goal now. I think we can make a break for it.
Make a break for it.
Yeah, let's just make a break for it outside of the fence. And then as soon as we see it, we'll just squeeze inside the fence.
Okay. Within about a minute, less than
that. Or if we wait here, the dogs will show up and keep killing them.
And I'll grab Serenity, pull her. We're going to Dog's Hour. Don't worry about it.
Within a couple of seconds, you're met at the fence by these dogs that are starting to squirm their way through the fence. Riot, you've got three of these dogs that are at the fence with you right now. Three more behind them. These ones are just trying to squirm their way through the fence to get at you. Is anybody at the fence in range of the dogs? Was anybody walking that close to the fence?
Serenity is.
Okay, so right now they're all looking to take a bite out of Serenity, but you have the initiative right now.
Serenity does or Riot?
Riot does.
Okay. Riot's going to take advantage of their interest in Serenity to try and squeeze through the fence.
Okay. Squeezing through the fence just means it... When you squeeze through a space, you can only do so at half movement, so I'll let you use half your movement to squeeze through the fence.
Okay. And once I'm on the other side, what direction did they come from?
I mean, you see three more coming from just slightly off to your left. We have the keep off to your left proper. They came kind of catty corner from it. So their kennel must be off in another corner of the fence, set apart from the keep. It's a separate building.
Okay. I'm going to move my full distance in.
Okay.
As far as I can. And then for my actual action, I'm going to cast Mirror Image, if that works.
You're not on Easeguard anymore.
I know, but I'm still so nervous about everything.
You should be. And that's a second level spell, right?
Yeah.
Typically, when you cast the spell, you get three illusory duplicates. Mm-hmm. Today, you get four.
Huh.
So there are now five U's standing in and around you. Now, moving your full distance forward, you're going to be intercepted by these three dogs. And trying to move past them without disengaging means they all get a snap. Is that your intention?
Yeah. My intention is provoke, possibly, if necessary, with all these mirror images to kind of, like, handle.
Gotcha. And yeah, all three of them are going to take a snap at you with their reactions. Alright, so I'm going to let you tell me what happens, because I know the first roll determines whether they target you or a duplicate. So I rolled an 11, a 12, and a 16.
Okay.
You've got four duplicates, so they need a four or higher to hit you. Or, no, what is that?
Yeah.
Four or higher. How does this work?
I think it's a five. I think it's a five or higher at this point.
If you have three duplicates, you must roll a six or higher to change the attack's target to a duplicate. You only need a four or higher because you have one extra duplicate.
Yeah.
So you can change all three of these to a duplicate if you want.
Okay, let me try this. Yeah, easily done.
Okay.
So all three of these snap at...
Yeah, they snap at your duplicates, and the duplicates blink out as their teeth snap shut.
Well, hang on. An attack has to hit a duplicate, and the duplicate's AC is 10 plus my dex modifier. So what were those rolls again?
11, 12, and 18. Was it 18
right,
or
16? Two of the duplicates.
So one's still standing?
So I now have two duplicates left.
Yes. And the dogs have their attention on all of yous.
Yeah.
I heard that.
Now backwards dogs get a turn. We'll start with the ones on Serenity. That's a terrible roll on my part. I should feel ashamed of myself. They're snapping wildly at you and kind of slavering Serenity, but none of them find purchase with their teeth. Then the three that are on Riot, Riot, and Riot. Miss, miss, and only one hit. Only one out of the three hit. So you've got two left, so you need what? A 10 or better?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
No, an 8 or better.
An 8 or better, okay.
But they actually hit me.
Okay, they got you, so you still have all your duplicates.
Yeah, so what's the damage of the one that hit?
It's going to be... six piercing damage from the bite.
Oof, okay.
Brings us to Serenity.
So who's standing near me right now?
Everybody but Riot. Riot squeezed her way into the fence and ran forward, and then suddenly there were five of her, and now she's engaged with the three dogs in front of you.
Elsa Clone, are you carrying weapons outwardly?
Nope.
Mahogany, are you carrying weapons outwardly?
No.
Okay. Damn. Riot, do you have a short sword?
I have a rapier.
Okay. Well, that's a shame. I'll squeeze through the fence, burn range, and kill, unfortunately, just one dog. Because okay. I can't find a second weapon to dual wield.
Kill.
But if somebody had one, I'd take off of them and dual wield.
There is a very sharp rock right here at your
you
feet.
Oh, really? Can I use that as a gun?
Right next, right here next to the fence. It's got a wicked edge to it.
Would it function as the club?
It would function as just a bludgeoning attack.
Well, I mean, I just need something that's light so I can use it in two attacks.
Yeah, it's light enough to hold one hand. It's not
okay,
a club
so
per se, but...
I'll grab the rock, I'll put my maul on my back, pull out my hand axe, let's go ahead and kill some dogs.
Alright.
So, hand axe attack.
It's
a natural one.
Mine's taken out of contest.
And then the second attack,
it's a bonus action with a bonus to the damage.
Right. That sounds close.
So should I use the staff or club on this? D4 light.
Yeah, use the. That's bludgeon. Fine. That sounds good. I was gonna make it a D4. Anyway, so that sounds right. That's the equivalent of a monk's unarmed attack. So that's in the bright ballpark.
12 on armor class.
And that hits.
For one damage.
So. You reach down, I mean, you're looking at... You hold two weapons, I got two hands, why not? So you get out your maul, and reach down and pick up this kind of heavy-looking rock. It's got some good heft to it. You figure, if I hit anything in the head with this, it's going down. And you do, you catch one upside the head, and try to follow up with a maul strike, but... Man, that impact felt so good. You take a moment to revel in it. And miss with
well,
your
it'd feel
attack.
Better if it died, but we can always hit it next time.
It's not dead, but it's really mad. Mahogany.
Alright, well, I am going to transform into a wolf. Wolf seems like a good choice of creature.
You do get pack tactics if you do that, which is nice.
Mm-hmm. I'm just trying to see, because I thought there was a dire wolf that is in here. Yes, here it is.
You already said wolf, though. You said I'm transforming into a wolf.
A dire wolf's a wolf.
Yeah, but you're a cipher, and you said I'm transforming into a wolf. So that happened.
A dire wolf's a wolf.
A dire wolf's a dire wolf.
No. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to go with Rick on this one.
No, they're two very different creatures, my friend.
They have different stat blocks.
So if I say I do something and I don't know what I'm saying, I do it even though I have no idea?
I don't buy the argument that you didn't know what I transform into a wolf means.
it's a dire wolf. All right.
You're either wolf now or you lose your turn. We'll put it that way.
Doesn't matter.
All right. So Nodal transforms into a wolf. As a wolf, you are bigger and stronger than these dogs, very clearly. You've got any kind of size and strength advantage against them. So what's next?
So I'm going to try to tear the one off of Riot.
Okay. You can maneuver around.
I'm trying to say orphan like five times.
You can maneuver around the ones around Serenity without provoking attacks because you can make that movement. That's fine. So which Riot are you trying to protect? Because there's three of them.
Closest one.
Alright, roll it. You get advantage on this roll, don't forget. Pack tactics.
It's not gonna matter. 12.
12 hits.
That didn't matter.
Yeah.
Let me get my...
Backwards dogs aren't very good at dodging.
They're not very good at dogging. how does 9 do you? 9 damage.
Catch it on the spine with your teeth and just shake your head viciously back and forth, and the thing yelps out loud, and then you drop it and it stops moving.
Everyone else gets to have all fun.
Give me 1 second. I didn't give these guys an XP. Okay, now they have an XP total. El Ciclon.
Squeeze through the bars, charge over to where the rest of the guys are, and start taking out wolves.
So, when you say the rest of the guys, you mean Riot and Mahogany?
Yeah. And Riot.
And each of those riots can make more riots, and then the whole world will just be filled with riots. Yeah, there are still two living wolves. You see, you're watching Mahogany shake one to death as you get up there.
I'll hit one of the other ones that's obviously still up.
Do it.
Or 18 to hit.
That hits.
4 damage.
4 damage? Okay, that's... You see...
Still up.
Yeah.
Key point for Flurry of Blows.
Ooh. My man's getting serious.
Ooh. 11 and 13.
The 11 does not hit. The 13 does.
Ooh, there goes all the dice. Another 5 damage.
Okay. So, you come in with a sweeping kick to get down to the thing's level. Knock its leg out from under it. You hear the bones snap, and it leans forward as it comes to the ground, and you lay in with a flurry of blows in and about its head and neck until it stops moving. Riot, you now outnumber the wolves 3-1.
You're the tyranny of the maturity.
Let's see. Right. I'm going to make a break for it. I'm going to use a double move.
Not disengage?
Not disengage. Toward the direction of the kennel.
It's going to snap at you. And that's a hit.
That's what mirror image is for.
Yep.
Alright, let's see.
You're good.
Yeah.
So, you know...
I lose another one of the...
The Riot twins are running towards the kennel. And the thing attempts to snap at it. One of the triplets vanishes into the mist. And you make your full movement there. Moving a full, what, 60? Or is it 80?
60, yeah.
60? Moving your full 60...
Not orphan anymore.
The only light in the area is coming from a third floor window on the keep. But you see the building of the kennel in front of you, and you hear more dogs inside that have taken up barking. Okay. And you hear the sound of chains rapping violently, as though these dogs are pulling against them really hard. But on your next turn, you'll be able to move into the doorway. Backwards dogs. I'm going to give them a chance to break off their chains and eat Riot. Which they failed. That's fine. Serenity still has three dogs on her. Or is it only two? Did you kill one? I don't think you killed one.
Has he killed anything?
No, I haven't killed anything.
Try it.
Serenity. Your AC 15 hits, right?
Yeah.
But I'm assuming an 11 does not?
No.
Okay. 12 points piercing damage. These dogs continue to snap at you. Their teeth scratch against the flesh of your arms and legs.
This is going to be more fun to kill them later.
And it's, well, it's your turn right now. So, oh, no, okay. It's not. Well, there's one more.
Oh.
Who misses Mahogany. So now Mahogany has one of the dogs snapping at him.
All right, so we'll take a swing hand axe.
Okay. I don't know that we like the sight of you, Serenity.
That'll hit an armor class of 8.
No, 8 doesn't hit.
And we'll take another bonk with rock.
Hey!
Hey!
Uh-oh.
That'll hit an armor class of 5.
Yes.
For 4 damage.
You beat this thing's skull in, the one that you hit previously. You cave in the side of its face. Its eye bursts in its socket. Yelps, crumples to the ground, and
throws across Serenity's face.
You look at the other two.
Ciclon is very scared around.
That brings us to Mahogany.
Alright, so what's the current state of this? I got one on me, and Serenity has one on her.
Here's the current state. There's one on you. Riot has broken and has run forward, and as she does so, you start hearing more ferocious barking from that direction. Behind you, Serenity had 3, and when you turn and look briefly, you watch as Serenity caves one's head in with a rock. You're also now starting to hear shouting from up above in the keep. And in one of the lit windows, you see a man, a backwards man, standing there, kind of frantically watching the activity down in the yard. But so far, he hasn't done anything. That's the state of things.
I am going to ignore the dog on me, and I'm going to go try to knock unconscious one of the dogs on Serenity.
Okay, so it's going to take a snap at you as you run. Oh, no, it can't. It already tried to take a snap at... What's her name?
Oh, good.
So you're running back to Serenity, easily enough. You cover the distance. Mm-hmm. Don't forget your pack tactics. Didn't matter.
Well, I rolled a 6. So.
Turn it on, not matter. Roll damage.
That's 8 plus... 2 is 10 piercing damage.
And that's enough. You rip the next... Are you trying non-lethal, right?
I was trying to knock it unconscious, but I want to, like, bloody it a little so that it looks like it's dead.
Well, it's already bloody because it's been scrapping with Serenity for a couple rounds. All right. But you grab this thing by the neck and twist it away from the fight, throw it away from the melee, and it lands with a thud and rolls over on its side. But you see it's still breathing.
Okay.
Elsie Clone.
I'm looking back and forth between the two, Riot and I'm looking back to Riot, and then the clone or Mahogany and Serenity. Go after Riot.
Are you disengaging from the dog or just running?
Disengage from the dog.
Oh, you know you don't have to. It doesn't have a reaction anymore. I just said that last turn and then forgot.
And just to make sure that I have enough movement to get over there, I can bend, burn a surge of speed to get over there.
Well, if you take the dash,
up
if
by
you,
30 feet.
If you take the dash action and burn that surge of speed, you'll get all the way into the kennel this round. Because I said it was 30 feet in front of Riot, and she dashed from you last round.
Okay, I'll do that then. So I'll get inside the kennel.
Are you holding the plants? You are.
Yeah.
Okay. So as soon as you get to the doorway of the kennel,
he's the one with the plant. Yeah.
The portal blares open in front of you in the doorway of the kennel. You hear the dogs very faintly now on the other side, being drowned out by the sounds coming through the portal, which you recognize as the city streets of Sigil.
Oh, well, my eyes will go wide, and then I'll shout over my shoulder, "Get over here now!"
Riot.
Go through the portal.
Riot leaps through the portal. Let's give these dogs a chance to break free and get into Sigil. They do not.
Both of us went through the portal.
No, Ciclon did as well?
No, I did not. I'm waiting for the other two to get through.
No, both of me.
Both of you, okay. Gotcha. Yeah, it's fine. Dogs. I gotta look up the spell, actually. Sorry for the delay. So, Mahogany and Serenity, you're back at the fence still, and you hear Ciclon yell, "Everyone get over here now!"
Do I see the dogs run through the portal?
No dogs ran through the portal. I was talking about the dogs who were chained up inside the kennel, but none of them broke their chain. If they had, they would have jumped in the portal after Riot. Mahogany, 12 points of force damage. As this man standing on this third floor balcony lowers a wand and launches magic missiles down into the yard, all three of which strike you, blow you backwards against this fence. And then the dogs will attack. The first dog's going to run after LC Clone, so it doesn't get to attack anything. It'll only reach the portal this round. There's two more dogs sitting at the fence. Mahogany. Mm-hmm. An additional 9 points of piercing damage. Whew, good roll. From the dog. And Serenity, does a 13 hit?
Alright, so I transform back into a human and take some damage.
Okay.
About human.
Well, transform into a human, that doesn't count as an animal. You can't wild shape into a human. So that's it for your wolf form? It's over? Wolf form's over?
Yeah, that form's done.
And the other dog attempts to snap at Serenity, but misses. So, these force bolts come seemingly out of nowhere and crash into you. And just as you're about to regain your feet, this dog rips into you, grabs you across the snout, starts tearing the flesh from your nose. And before you know it, you're Mahogany again. Serenity's turn.
Don't do it.
If you didn't do it, it'd just be bad roleplay.
I know.
Is he muted?
And I can't support that.
I can't hear him if he's saying anything.
Yeah, it was on mute, sorry. First she's going to smash the downed dog, unconscious one, with a rock.
Okay.
That'll hit, and it'll deal 8 damage.
To reach that dog, you have to move out of the threat range of the other two, though, because Mahogany threw it away from the melee.
Oh, okay, well, first I'll kill one of the ones I'm in melee with, so let me do that first.
For 8 damage?
Well, that was on the unconscious one, so I was rolling at advantage, and I was auto-critting. The normal attack will hit an armor class of 16.
Yeah, it's more than enough. You're fine.
4. 10 damage.
10 damage? That's good enough. Was that with the maul or the rock?
That's the hand axe.
The hand axe.
One hand, rock in the other.
Why do I keep thinking maul?
I put my maul away. It's two-handed, so.
Yeah, you bring the axe down and just split this thing's skull in half.
That's satisfying. I'm going to move away from the other dog recklessly.
Okay, it'll snap.
Because there's the one on the ground, it'll be easier to smash.
It doesn't hit you.
And then I'm going to just keep it roll, so it's going to take 6 damage to the unconscious one.
And it's not unconscious anymore, now it's dead. It already had a pretty deep wound, just in one of its shoulders, just beneath its neck. But it's breathing weakly, you just bring this rock down on its head. And it splits very satisfyingly, so now it's just the one dog left.
I guess I'll regretfully use the rest of my movement to go towards Portal, but I'm already lining up throwing my axe at the last dog.
We still have one at the fence, don't we? Or are all of those dead?
That was the one that snapped at me, I think.
Right. So, Mahogany, you've got one dog on you. Serenity is just reveling in the destruction right now.
I transform into a direwolf? And now I'm a large beast. Can I pick up Serenity in my mouth?
No. No, that would be very dangerous for Serenity. Serenity could...
No, that's fine.
...probably safely
I'm
ride
not, I'm not asking to do no damage. I'm asking if I could pick her up.
If you roll a grappling attack against Serenity... let me think about this for a second. I'll give you the attack roll, but I would give it to you at disadvantage, because you're a large beast trying to carry a medium creature. And she's too big and heavy for you to carry easily in your mouth. But I'll let you make the roll.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Serenity, this is a grapple, so you can oppose this, if you want to oppose it, with either athletics or acrobatics.
It sounds like there's some more dogs over there.
There are more dogs.
No, I'm actually fine. I'm just being dragged around, and then
you're into. Okay. All right,
so you drag me around, and I'll just bring my axes around to the other dogs. This is gonna be great.
So
that's a 19.
That's good. So where do you move to then? Well, you come up behind Serenity. First of all, how do you pick her up?
I have 50 feet. I just bite down and grab her.
Just bite on like what part of her body?
Yeah, her chest.
And are you trying to, like, carry her, or are you just, like, dragging her along?
I'm trying to carry her.
Okay.
I'm just trying to run through that portal with a 50 feet of movement.
Okay. First thing you need to do is make a damage roll for your bite.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a D10. I don't need that. I don't do that much damage. Nope, that's... That's, 7. 7 piercing.
Serenity.
Yeah, so that's 4.
Okay.
Yeah, she's still up, barely.
Okay. Now make me a strength check. Straight up strength check. This is to ensure that you can make your full movement carrying this very awkwardly sized and shaped Earth Genasi along with you.
5.
If you 5 have belief points, this might be a good time.
Might need to belief point that shit.
Yeah, I'm going to use a belief point. And to you have to justify these, right? Using one of your beliefs?
If you're just looking to get advantage on the roll, you just spend 2 points and that's it. You don't have to justify them at all. Just spend the 2 points.
Oh, I thought it... Okay, yeah, well, I'll just spend the 2 points.
Okay.
Actually, would it make sense for Nodal to spend 2 of my belief points, since out of character I would less to happen?
No, because you can't use your inspiration to give him advantage on his roll.
Okay.
I was going to say that clearly this plane is affecting her, so this isn't her perfect form, and I'm trying to get her off.
That's definitely true. That's very, very obvious.
That's good.
So, correct me if I'm wrong, but right now, I mean, Serenity is clasped tight in Mahogany's jaws. But she's just looking forward, holding the axe, like, we're looking for, like, a batter-up situation when we come to intercept this dog.
Yeah, I'm just gonna get Rick brought up. I'm assuming you will bring into the reach of more dogs.
I will let you use your reaction if you want to take a swing at this dog that's coming towards you.
The dog being the one we're running past?
Yes, as you blow
hell
past
yeah.
it. Alright. I'll let you take that.
That would be a 19.
19 hits.
Guys, this is wacky heck.
Or 8 damage.
8 damage. Mahogany, I need a strength saving throw. Make this at disadvantage.
Okay.
8. Here's what happens. Serenity is very difficult to carry, because while she did not put up any resistance to being lifted, she's moving strangely as though she's trying to turn around and see where you're running to, which is causing you no end of difficulty, because she's twisting inside of your mouth. And to your horror, you see her rear back with her axe and take a swing, which catches this dog in between its jaws. The skull buries itself into the back of the dog's skull, and the weight of it spins you unnaturally, and you collapse into the ground into a big heap, all three of you.
Is it dead?
Oh, it's dead.
Oh, yeah. How far are we from the portal?
You made it about halfway there when you intercepted the dog, so another round of full movement will get you there. But before that, Mahogany, 23 points of force damage. The figures up on the third floor has now been joined by a backwards woman, and they're both lobbing magic missiles down at you with their wands, and there's breaking bones. You feel your ribs inside your wolf form give way as they just pummel into you. Serenity.
Yeah.
You're being grappled. And there's nothing left to kill here except Mahogany.
There's no dogs left?
There's one that's chasing you. The one that Mahogany left at the fence is chasing you.
Oh, yeah. But... No, it's getting a thrown axe.
Okay. Throw it.
That should hit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For 4 damage.
You throw this axe and you hear this...
No, 6 damage.
6? Okay, sorry. Yeah, it's a little better.
Yeah, sorry.
You hear the loud yelp as you catch it in its haunch, and the thing spins into the dirt, yelps loudly.
Still up?
No, it stopped. Stopped moving.
Okay. I guess at this point I can try and drag this towards the... I'm grappled, so either just can attempt to move the other, right?
Yes.
Yeah, let's drag the wolf. This is going to be a strength, I take it?
Actually, it's a large creature. I'll let you move it up to a quarter of your movement.
Okay. Is that just automatics?
Yes, that's fine.
And you still need to make
as,
a strength.
As long as Mahogany doesn't try to... Well, Mahogany can't resist it, I guess.
Wait, Mahogany, are you still wolf after 24 damage?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I'm a really big...
Awesome. So, yeah, I'll just kind of leave you up over my shoulders and start heading towards that portal, laughing maniacally the whole way, dropping my rock.
Mahogany, what do you
do? Oh, man, we got to come back here sometime. This is great.
Your turn, Mahogany.
Yeah, I'm dragging this chuckle fuck all the way rest of the way through the portal. If you need me to make any more bite attacks, you just let me know.
Mahogany, 9 points of force damage. And
hey,
Serenity,
guys. I was waiting.
Oh, Serenity's unconscious.
Oh. Well, the magic missiles come raining down just as you come to the kennel itself, blasting
Burgred,
into you.
If it matters, I was waiting until Serenity and Mahogany made it through. So I was still there. Still there waiting at the...
I thought you jumped through with Riot and
no,
Riot.
No. I wanted to make sure these guys got through.
Oh, well, what was it you wanted to do? There was nothing left for you to fight.
There wasn't anything left for a fight. I'm just to make that a point of distinction that I did with them.
Well, then standing where you're standing, as soon as they reach the kennel, you see the streaks of these magic missiles come through the mist. Serenity falls at your feet unconscious. What happens to Mahogany? Are you still up?
Mahogany is still up, but Serenity doesn't fall down because I'm holding her.
Okay, well, she goes slack in your mouth as you reach the portal. Well, at this point, the portal would have closed, and Ciclon would have had to open it again.
And I run through the freaking portal as soon as it opens.
Yeah.
And so you all get back into Sigil. You come out in the lower ward. The back door of some boarded-up building.
Need to make sure that Mahogany isn't going to... Or Serenity isn't going to bleed out.
No, I as soon as we get through the portal, we're in a relatively safe place, right?
For certain values is relatively safe. Yeah, I mean, you're in the lower ward, not the hive.
Good enough. I turn back into a human and I shove some berries down my throat. Okay. They take one round, so it does take some time.
Okay.
Well, the first one will get me conscious again.
The first one will get you conscious.
Do I still feel that that effect of the abyss?
You do not. What was the name of that keep? I didn't make a note of it.
It was Corlach Keep.
Corlach.
Serenity.
And as soon as
what
you come back,
what the hell just happened?
Mahogany shoves another berry in your throat.
What the hell?
We got home, finally. That's what happened.
Maybe, I don't know. Look out a window if there's one available.
I never thought I'd be so happy to see these terrible, dusty streets.
I've been on the lower plains before, but that's never happened.
Elsie Clone.
I don't like it.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Elsie Clone.
Yo.
The plant in your hand, as soon as you enter into Sigil, you feel a stinging sensation. Looking down, your hand is coated in blood.
I'll drop it.
There's nothing to drop. It's disintegrated and your hand is covered in blood.
My own, or...?
It's just blood.
Good question.
No idea whose it is.
Wipe it off.
On who? So what's next?
If you look over at Mahogany, he's just going to growl at you.
Oh, the Abyss was fun.
No mood.
The Abyss was not fun.
So what's next?
Alright, so what did we get?
Well, we've got this parcel.
Yeah.
Sit back to Serenity's and open it.
I need a few minutes to rest.
You're fine, let's go.
How many berries did you shove down my throat?
How many do you want?
Well, I was at negative 19. I was at negative. Where's my points?
Well, the negative doesn't matter.
Yeah, there's no negative.
Negative doesn't exist anymore.
Right. However many you want to shove. Like, just one, I guess, if we're just in Sigil. I can rest.
No, I give you, like, 10 berries. And I say, okay. You keep eating these, and don't talk while you're eating them. It ruins the magic.
So you guys are heading back to Serenity's tenement?
Yeah.
Sounds good.
Hey, bear with me just one second so I can figure out exactly which day it is here.
It's Green Beer Day.
We went back in time.
I've been keeping track of the days while you've been out of Sigil, so... It's not...
So does the multiverse follow Sigil time? Is that like Greenwich Mean Time?
Yeah, Sigil Standard Time.
Time runs different on every plane. So... There's really no answer to that question. There is no standard time. You could leave Sigil for a week, and if you're on a particular plane, come back, and maybe only a day has passed, or maybe several weeks have passed. It depends on where
it's
you go and what
ass.
You do.
It's a pain in the ass to work with, because every now and then the outland shifts a little bit, and they have to add a leap second.
As you're making your way back through town, though, you notice there are many members of the Aethar out on the streets, giving speeches about the false gods and whatnot, which is an indication to you that it is an astral day. Astral days are days
that my eyes.
Kind of break up the months. They stretch the weeks out longer one day, so it's probably the first astral day, most likely.
Aren't you an Aethar?
He's a godsman.
No, he's a godsman.
Godsman.
I thought that was the same thing.
The Aethar are the atheists. They're the ones that believe the gods are false.
The gods are the ones
right,
that think
that's what
everyone
I thought
can
the
be god.
The gods are the ones who believe that they can become gods.
Oh, okay, got
yeah.
it.
They're pretty much diametrically opposed.
Kind of, yeah. The Aethar don't like the godsmen much because the godsmen, they see the godsmen as being kind of power hungry. They're trying to become gods, and the gods are all extremely powerful egoists who don't care about mortals. Ergo, the godsmen. You see where we're going with that. It would be the first astral day. The Aethar, the astral days are their days in Sigil, more or less. The astral plane is the plane that represents their faction. So tomorrow would be the 16th, which is Worms Day, which is a pretty fun day. It's the day where They essentially clean out the prison and feed a whole bunch of prisoners to the worm. The 17th is the day that Riot's handbills are due to be done.
How many days until that?
The 17th, so 2 days from now.
Okay. Glad we're running on Riot time.
So the last thing we'll do tonight, we'll go back to Serenity's tenement and trying to open up the package.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
We're
opening this friggin' package.
Question one, who's doing it?
Riot is.
I'm doing it.
No?
Unless Riot, like, literally is holding the package and opens it as we get inside.
Riot is literally holding the package.
It's in her pack.
Okay, so
then Riot's doing it.
How does Riot open the package? It's just a small brown cube tied with string.
Like? Is it, like, tied with string?
Yep, just tied with string.
Take out the boot dagger and slice open the string.
And you find it impossible. The dagger does not cut the string. Feels like you're pulling against really strong metal wire.
Can it be untied?
Yeah, it's just tied in a knot.
Alright, let's try and untie it then.
I'll chuckle at that.
As you begin untying it, the knot is more complicated than it looked at first. And watching the string, the other of you, Riot, you do not notice it. The others do. But as she's untying the string, it seems that the string elongates and begins slithering up her hand and starts to wrap around each of her wrists.
Yeah, at that point, I'm going to grab the string and pull it away from her. It starts to wrap around her wrists.
Okay, so you kind of grab the box away, and as soon as she stops tying, the strings retreat back into the completed knot.
What the hell, Serenity? I almost had that thing open.
It was going to grab your... Didn't you see the...
It was grabbing your wrists.
It was grabbing your... Yeah, it was.
You're just saying that.
No, it was... It was trying to tie itself around your wrists, which is... That's interesting, but you know
tie
what?
It and watch it next time.
Here, I'll untie it. You make sure it doesn't, I don't know, tear my arms off. And I'll start untying it.
Serenity begins untying it, the same thing happens. The string begins to slither up her hand and begin wrapping itself around her wrists.
See, it's unsettling, right?
Ugh.
Does anybody stop her?
Yeah, that would have been you. I'm start trying to pull that string away from her.
Serenity, now you're pretty... You don't think what just happened was what just happened. When you started untying it, you didn't notice anything was askew at all.
I didn't see it.
You didn't see it. Or feel it, for that matter.
No, I'm just telling the others I didn't see it.
Okay.
That's weird.
Alright, well, keep pulling on that string.
Well, I can't cut it. Can't untie it. Any other ideas?
What's the note say?
It says don't open it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but clearly we were always going to open it, right?
Right.
No, I mean, right. We weren't going to fall. No. Like, let's be real here.
Who was originally going to get this package out of character?
Diller.
Diller. Do we know who that is?
It was his man Ben. Was supposed to be the one to pick it up.
Right, but who's going to deliver it? It was going to be delivered to Diller?
Yes.
There's no delivery instructions. All it says is, retrieve it, don't open, we'll be back by the time you return.
Yep.
Diller might be back in town already.
We might want to go talk to that guy.
We set him free. He's in prison now.
Right.
You want to go into the prison? Be my guest.
Well, last you saw him, you released him into the custody of the Harmonium.
Right, which is another way of saying he's in prison by now.
No, prison would be the Mercy Killers. It's a question of what the Harmonium did to him.
That's true.
So, the last thing I think...
Riot's assumption is just that he's in prison.
He's in prison, okay. I think the last thing we'll do this session, then, is because I do believe Serenity had enough experience to level up, did she not?
Probably twice at this point.
All right,
yeah,
then...
I'm still level one.
I'm going to go ahead and post the straw poll link in the chat again. As soon as I can find my chat window. There it is. There's the link.
We have some time some downtime to level.
You will have, because I want to, when we pick it up next week, I want to start right in with Worms Day, so you will have tonight in Sigil to do with what you will. So you'll have enough to take, like, one nighttime action.
How long does it take to gain a level?
You're fine with that. You can do all the leveling up you need to in that time.
Okay.
Alright.
I can also gain a level, but I'm a little concerned that I'm not being given any time to learn any new spells. Like, I have new spells coming to me, but, mm-hmm. like, there's just been no break in the action ever.
Well, you're back in Sigil now, so you'll have that opportunity will come. I mean,
okay.
Yeah, out in the fields, you're not... Well, unless you're, like, dungeon hacking,
no,
you
no,
come
no,
across
I mean,
a horde.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying that, like, I wanted to level up during that session. Because I know it's a downtime action, and I'm fine doing that tonight. It's just...
Okay.
Been difficult.
That's...
As a rule of thumb, any spell in the PHB... It would be relatively easy for you to get access to. It's just a matter of finding a wizard who will scribe you a scroll out of their spellbook, which is just the standard cost of a scroll. So just as a downtime action, you can purchase those.
Wait, does she need a scroll? She's a bard.
She does, yes. Because she has to learn the spells from okay. somewhere. It's not like yeah. it's not like Eldov who just got the magic from his awesome blood.
Yeah, I... What I figured I was doing was learning them from my new bandmates, one of whom is a bard.
Yeah, you could do that too. So when you go to level up, how many new spells do you get when you level?
I gotta look at the PHB. I haven't learned any in a while.
I'll let you make a charisma check to determine whether or not he'll teach you magic from his own repertoire.
Okay.
So, yeah, I just posted the straw poll in the chat. That is... You guys get to decide who's getting a piece of bonus experience this session. Before that, though, before I check that, we're going to go down the role-playing list here. Where's my experience sheet? Oh, it's on the portal sheet, maybe? Yes. I gave Serenity two blips of experience, one for role-playing alignment. Serenity's take on neutral good is... Good is helping the weak and less fortunate, and in Riot's moment of weakness, Serenity helped carry her stretcher. I also gave the one blip for playing into that abyssal flaw. Because you, Serenity gave the owners of the keep ample opportunity to rain magic missiles down on you guys when you could have just broken for the exit and been through. I also gave one blip to Mahogany because his flaw, which is I'm not sure I'm doing this right, came into play while he was leading everybody through the forest and not getting anywhere. So we give one blip to the person who had the most creative action of the session. Who was the most? What was the most creative action to happen this session? Who thought outside the box?
I did like Mahogany taking using direwolf form to take Serenity in his jaws and just running.
So, like, is that kind of despite the damage dealt, or is the damage dealt part of it?
That's kind of part of it.
Okay. Is anybody seconding Mahogany?
I'll second that.
Okay. We have 1 point for heroism. Who was the most heroic this week in their travails through the Grey Waste and the Abyss?
Well, who killed the most backward dogs? Come on.
That was like 80 needed... heroism. Serenity was like stopping to kill.
It needed to be done.
Can you lose heroism points?
No.
She even ate the opportunity attack to make sure that the one that was just wounded was killed. Come on.
Is that really heroic, though?
No, it isn't.
No, it really is not.
I was waiting for Serenity to break off and start slaughtering peasants in the fields, honestly.
It's tempted.
It's like, that's why I put those peasants there.
It was just listed as fun, not necessarily something she had to do, but...
So who is getting heroism this week? If not Serenity for slaughtering dogs.
I don't think anyone acted particularly heroic this week.
All of those dogs needed to die. That's all I'm going to say.
Let me put it this way. If nobody else votes someone for heroism, I'm going to give it to Serenity for killing those dogs.
Is this a point of contention? Is it 2-2 on the point of the dogs?
I really don't want to kill those dogs.
You said that.
Yeah, we did say that.
Yeah.
Alright, we'll give Granite to Serenity for brutally murdering a lot of dogs.
She earned a lot of EXP in that throwing.
Wow.
I gotta add up how many XP that was, actually. I'll do that in a second. We give a blip for whoever was the most badass. Who was the biggest badass this week?
I did pile driver that fish man. That was pretty good.
Yeah, no, that was good. I like the fish man.
Pile driving the fish
pile
man.
Driver.
I like that. I'll
That's fine.
That.
And we give one blip for intangibles. Anything we missed? Any random stuff that might deserve it?
I enjoyed the apathy out of Riot.
Yeah.
See, I'm not going to give it to the Riot for that. I'm going to give it to Riot because of the sick fish burns.
Like, is there any relation to Lawrence Fishburne? Oh, see what I did there? Oh, the guy. Oh,
all right, well, this campaign is over. It's been Planescape, everyone.
Yeah, thank you very much. Good night, everybody.
All right, and so I'm going to check the straw poll now, and Mahogany has a very, very commanding lead in the straw poll. So what was it, chat, that Mahogany did that was so awesome this week? What? We'll look in the chat here in a minute as I'm counting up experience. But you did something the chat really liked.
I think they just like dire wolves, really.
They just like it when I say things. I mean, so do I.
Who doesn't?
So Killian got Bupkis this week. Let me do some quick calculations here. Just bear with me one moment.
Yeah, I'm kind of glad Keeling wasn't there for negotiating with Charon. Somebody just said that in chat.
Okay.
Apparently people like the drop bear.
Drop bear is pretty good.
Okay, so...
Is Fener carry, Fireman's carry, Jerugu?
I'm gonna give Serenity her base experience first. Because Serenity's base experience will level her up to where her blips are worth more. So that seems like a thing to do.
All these people need to be very clear. That was when I was a dire wolf, which is very different than a wolf.
They got difference? Do you deny it? I mean, if there's no difference, why are you so butthurt you didn't get it the first time? If they're the same thing, I mean. Serenity, I'm going to award you your encounter experience first.
Okay.
In fact, let's just make... 100... Anytime we get to the end of a session where there's some downtime, I'll make a point to do this first. That way you get the full amount of your blips.
Sure.
So you got 705.
Well, that'll... Jeez. Okay, that's third level, not quite fourth.
Wow, and then he gets
what's
the
fourth
blips.
Level?
Fourth is 2700. They go you through third really quickly, so you get your basic class features.
So that definitely puts Serenity up to third.
Yeah.
Okay.
705.
Yes, and then on top of that, the three blips that you have are worth an additional 270. So if I did all the math right, you're sitting at 1755. Is what I've got here. Okay.
Oh, great. Now I have to pick which type of barbarian I want to be when I grow up.
Huge.
And everybody gets that 705 for the encounter XP. That's 705. For the fishmen's and the dogs, and you got a little bit of additional experience because I threw two more magic missile-wielding dudes in the fight after that.
How much experience do I get knocking out Serenity?
You didn't knock out Serenity. Magic missile did.
Oh, that's true. Next time.
Does anybody else? Else up
I'm
over
not,
level?
I'm up to three.
You're up to three. Okay.
I have always been at three.
I'm third level. It'll be level three blips for me as well.
Riot, you get an additional 90.
Mm-hmm.
Which, from my spreadsheet, gives you 1912 experience. Does that sound right?
Let me do my own math here, but I'll confirm that in a second.
LC Clone, you also will get 90 from your blips.
My math at 1732. There's an anonymous wall that was looking at my character sheet. I don't know how I feel about that.
I've got you at 1702 for experience. You said you had 1732?
Yeah.
Okay, then I will adjust that.
I have 19. I have 1942, Brick.
42, so you guys have 30 experience that I forgot to give you, or I didn't notate from somewhere.
Missing blip, maybe?
Could be. They're easy to lose. Serenity, we've already... I already gave you your blip experience, right? Your extra...
Yep. Okay. Yeah, she's full up now.
Mahogany, you're getting an extra 270 from blips this session.
Okay.
Which, from my notes, puts you at 2062. Grand total. So you guys are all on road to level 4 at this point. Except poor Keelian, who...
decided not to come.
Yeah, he sucked anyway.
Yeah, he's stuck in the... We leave Keely in the Mega Bliss. Can we do that?
Okay, so I have to ask. When Keelian comes back, he has the cat, right?
You have to ask
the
that?
The cat never showed up.
You'll have to okay. Wait till next week to find out. Anybody who wants, I will give you your... Because you're going up to level 3, I'll let you read these like little extra subclasses that I have, like the college names and the way of balance for monks and that kind of stuff. If you're not interested in any of that and you just want to go out of the PHB, that's fine too.
Can you send me that?
Yeah,
or
same
did,
here.
Did you already?
Yeah, I could.
The college
like
names is
that.
Really good.
Okay. I thought I sent all of them out, but maybe I just sent Nodals and McDohl.
Was it like a shared thing?
It would have been a link, so I'm going to throw it up in web space for now.
Okay.
In the web zone.
Okay, then I will do that as soon as we shut the game down here.
Alright.
Let me go into... I just want to go into chat here and find out why they gave all those... Why Mahogany ran away with this week's blip.
I'm just completely shocked that the one time I run away win, you don't accuse me of cheating.
Well, I just expect it now. I just know you're cheating. I don't even have to ask you about it. Let's do some belief rundown now.
Drop there. Who
wants to go first?
What I'm hearing here.
I'll go first.
Mahogany. Let me get Mahogany's page up here. Mahogany's belief is there's one perfect state of being for everything, and some cannot be tolerated. So did Mahogany act in accordance with that belief?
Mm-hmm.
How so?
First of all, I argued with the people back at the camp of whether or not they should just go out and start hunting the demon.
Mm-hmm.
Or whether they should wait for it to be attack them first. And then I also brought Serenity's plain touched ass back into Sigil.
So what is, just out of curiosity, what is Mahogany's, like, how does that belief interact with the Abyss now that he's been there? Does the Abyss too have a perfect state of being?
He didn't really think much of the Abyss, because it just seemed like any cool, crappy place. But he was pretty strongly affected by the plane before that. What's the name of it? The Grey Waste.
The Grey Waste.
Which honestly seemed pretty fair as a plane. Like, it had a very dear thing that it was about, and it about it. Honestly, the plane in walking itself, all the planes seem very in tune with his beliefs.
Okay. Did Mahogany learn anything new about his belief?
They were kind of strengthened, because just as an example, several members of our party were acting differently due to influences from the planes. Like, Serenity at first missed all of those fucking attacks. So to Mahogany, that says that her natural state of being, even though it was being influenced, was still coming through.
So that strengthens his belief, but did he learn anything new?
No.
Okay. Are they changing?
No.
And who wants to go next?
I'll go next.
El Ciclon. Yep. Let me pull up your sheet here. You would think I'd do this ahead of time, so I don't have to pause awkwardly every time I come to this part of the session.
You'd think, but, you know, you never learn.
So right now your belief is it is a luchador's duty to be a hero to others through action. Did he act in accordance with those beliefs this week?
Yes and no. No when he popped off at Mahogany in the Abyss, and yes when he waited to make sure that everybody got through safely.
Okay, so he saw it as his duty as the one holding the key to make sure everybody got through the portal.
Exactly.
All right. Did he learn something new about his beliefs?
I would say I'm still trying to think how the shit from what he saw of Serenity and then how he himself acted in the abyss. Like, I'm trying to think how he sees that. And I mean, it's a matter of he still has an ideal for himself, and maybe it's being tempered a little bit, but not by much.
So when Elsie Clone was in the Gray Waste, and he's getting a little annoyed because the plane is getting to him, and he makes a suggestion, maybe we should follow the instructions and put Riot in charge, like the crazy woman said. And then 2 days later, after you guys got lost, that finally worked out. What were Elsie Clone's feelings about that while he was under the influence of the Gray Wastes?
Oh, no, like, that was the dumbest thing that could have possibly happened. Like, Ciclon, like Gray Waste Ciclon was not happy at all. So he would just spend a lot of the time fuming.
Okay. So, our Elsie Clones, well, we decided last week that I gave you some belief points contingent on his beliefs changing. So how are Elsie Clone's beliefs changing? And then there was silence.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to think of good like a good thesis statement that could be put back on the character sheet now. That's what I'm.
Well, develop the thought. What are you thinking? Like, what direction are you going in?
That the
Well, I see on the sheet that, here you added the line "temper the ideal versus reality." What does that mean?
Well, I mean. That's kind of my thought process that it's one thing to say, oh, I am heroic, I'm full of heroism, but sometimes it's just not possible because sometimes giant scary things are coming to eat your face or things like that. There's just some situations where the ideal of heroism, of charging bravely forward into the jaws of death, is just stupid.
And did we see an example of that this session or last session?
Oh, right at the beginning, yes, because right at the end of the last session, he was like, time to go, as soon as he heard that roar, and gotcha. That's where we stopped that last session. And,
okay. So yeah. what is his new belief, then? So the old one is it's a luchador's duty to be a hero to others through action. So is his belief, is he adding to what a luchador's duty is, or is he starting to change his definition of what a luchador is, or what heroism is, or what action is?
I think he's more changing his definition of what a hero is.
To what? Like, what is his new ideal of what a hero is? Knowing when to cut and run?
Yes.
Well, you did cut and run twice. Mm-hmm. Okay, so go ahead and change the ideal then. Think of a good way to phrase it. I will give you the point for it. And Riot. Let me pull up Riot's belief here.
While you're doing that, I have a question.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What's the question?
How much do people who have experienced the changes wrought in their personality on the other planes, how much do they remember of that?
They remember how they acted, and savvier planewalkers know what changes will happen ahead of time.
Okay.
So, but yeah, it's, you definitely remember Riot everything would remember, that happened.
Yeah, she remember being apathetic and all that stuff. Okay.
Right. At the time, it felt just natural, but if Riot were to do some research about the Gray Waste and learn how the plane affects people, then it would become very clear what happened. So I have Riot's belief as the oppression of the majority must be uprooted and destroyed at every opportunity. Did that come up at all in the along the sticks or in the woods?
She didn't act according to it. So the answer to that question is no.
How did she act in opposition to it.
Let's see. So, what I was going to get at was the second question of, like, did she learn anything new? I was going to say yes to that.
How so?
Because she realized that without people forcing her along and imposing their will on her, she would never have gotten out of that place.
Okay. And what kind of light does that shed on her anarchist beliefs?
So she's realizing that sometimes, like, people really do have your best interest in heart when you don't.
So are her beliefs changing?
I'm gonna say yes, but I don't have like a particular sentence in mind. But okay. I'll work on it for next session.
We'll work on it. Yeah, no problem. And Serenity, let's pull up your sheet here. You guys are seeing people log into the sheets because all the links work now on the site, so people are able to go and pull up your sheets and look. So don't type anything nasty about my viewers on your character sheet. Stop doing that immediately, Nodal.
Listen, if they weren't nasty, they wouldn't have me to read it.
I have Serenity down as, by my actions, I will make the universe a better place. So did Serenity act in accordance to that belief?
Not really.
No? So the universe is not a better place minus four of those dogs?
Well, it's a little bit better, but that was practically outside of her control.
Okay. Did she learn anything new about that belief?
Not particularly.
And are they changing?
No.
The big goose egg from Serenity. All right. Riot and Ciclon, I'm giving you 2 belief points this session. Mm-hmm. Mahogany, I'm giving you 1. And go ahead and do the leveling up as far as like your hit dice and stuff like that, and I will get those PDFs. I thought I had uploaded them already. If so, I'll just send you the links. If not, I will actually get them.
You might have uploaded them, and I didn't, but they weren't like emailed or something. I might have just lost one.
Dude, the past like 2 weeks, because of the holidays and everything, have just been a blur in my household. So yeah. It's entirely possible I meant to do it and didn't.
I feel like you probably did share them like months ago.
It's been so long. I'll fix it tonight. And there's a chance you don't want anything out of the sheet anyway. So that is going to bring us to the end of the session. I had a blast. I'm really glad I managed to power my way through it, even though I had only a modicum of time to plan anything.
I would not have guessed if you hadn't said anything, because that felt like a totally real plan session.
Well, I mean, that's the benefit of knowing your setting really, really, really well, I guess. Is being able to come up with stuff that feels genuine just off the cuff. I wouldn't be able to do that in Eberron, that's for sure.